buying a bike isn't always just about buying a bike. Like any other new toy, it's always about getting the add-ons. In this video, we'll be talking about the accessories that you really need to invest in if you're getting a new bike home. Stick around. But before we start, we would like to thank FastEnough for collaborating with us on the Beginner Cyclist series. FastEnough makes nutritional supplements to take care of your pre, intra and post-workout needs so that you get the max out of each and every workout session that you do. Check out their products on the Cycle of India website. We have left a link in the description box below. So without further ado, let's get started. The first accessory that we would like to recommend from our side is a good helmet. Why we say a good helmet is because we have seen people cheaping out. Even after investing in a 1 lakh rupee bike, they tend to buy a cheap helmet. This piece of equipment is really going to save your brains when you crash on your favorite downhill trail or when you are riding out there on the road. We would strongly urge everyone to buy a good branded helmet. I am using something from LeMar. This is primarily a road helmet which I use on both of my bikes. It is super light, provides great ventilation and comes with 2-year warranty. The second accessory on the list is a multi-tool. A multi-tool like this one from Burzuman can literally open each and every nut and bolt on your bike. If you are passionate about servicing your bike at home, getting things adjusted in the perfect way each and every time, or you do not want to end your ride in the middle of the road because of any loose parts, then you should seriously consider investing in a multi-tool. It can really be the difference between you continuing your ride or walking back home. At number 3 on the list is a spare tube and a mini pump. When that unexpected dreaded puncture happens in the middle of the road, you can easily swap the puncture tube with a new one, inflate this within 5 to 6 minutes with a mini pump and get going. When you're out there shopping for a mini pump, ensure that the mini pump has a small footprint. It should easily fit in your jersey back pocket without irritating you on the long rides and should be compatible with Strader and Presta walls. Next up on the list are lights. The golden rule while riding out there on open roads is to see and be seen. Especially with the winters and fog coming, it is very important to have a good light setup on your bike so that you feel and remain safe when you're starting your rides early in the day or riding late in the night. It is highly recommended to use 2 lights on your bike, one which is handlebar mounted to ensure that you can see in front of you in pitch darkness, and the other one should be seat post mounted so that you are visible to traffic that is coming from behind. Something like this one from Knight Rider, the Knight Rider Swift 500 and the Knight Rider Saber 80 serves the purpose for us. Number 5 on the list are riding glasses. Do they look nice? No, they really serve a purpose beyond making you look nice. These glasses protect you from all the debris that are coming straight towards your eyes when you're riding your MTB on one of those adventurous trails, and also protect your eyes from the wind blast when you're out touring on wide open roads. Riding glasses like this one from AGU come with interchangeable lenses. See these lenses that are there with the dark tinge right now? You can easily swap them out for clear lenses if you're riding early in the day or in the night. At number 6 on the list is a bike lock. I mean, I cannot stress enough on how important this is. If you really want to keep your prize position safe and enjoy it for a long time, then invest in a good bike lock. Do not cut corners here, otherwise somebody will cut this lock and take your bike away. If you are somebody who does not have a good dedicated parking for your bike, or you park your bike in the lift lobbies of your apartment, then investing in something like this is very important. Last but not the least, at number 7 on the list is something we call as the original puff. This magical piece of cloth can be used to keep your neck warm during winters, protect your ears as well as nose from the cold winds, and can also double up as a less restrictive pollution mask. Also, you can wear it on your head under your helmet to ensure that all the sweat does not damage the inner liner of the helmet. Apart from the few ways that I just showed you, this magical piece of cloth can be worn in 10 to 15 ways. You can see a video link in the top right corner right now that showcases how you can wear the Puff in multiple ways. So those were the accessories that we wanted to recommend to anyone who is starting out with cycling. Do let us know if you like the video or not. If you found this video useful, click the subscribe button and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.